Welcome back to Steven Sausage Roll. Last time we took on the Great Tower, the scary parts of the third dimension, trial by fire and all that. We came out the other side, but as we like to say in the puzzle industry, tutorial complete. We're in World 3 and I fully expect to be completely destroyed by the third dimension here, as well as advanced concepts. So let's get right into it, I suppose. Cold Jag. Yeah, we're in wintertime here, and wintertime, I think, has historically been a harder world in puzzle games. I'm not sure if necessarily in action games for sure, although there's ice levels, which are kind of a similar thing here. We're totally doing log rolling here, aren't we? Yeah, of course we are. Anyway, but as I was saying, it's kind of connected to the passage of time. That's kind of what's been observed here. The puzzle creator knows that we have beaten Worlds 1 and 2, so they know they can really pull out all the stops on their metaphorical organ here. Yeah, so... Alright. Right, so... So this is all going to be about mounting and dismounting here. Yeah, I am super trapped here. That ain't going to go. That ain't going to work. So here's our log rolling tutorial. An episode after we experimented with it and then decided it was probably not a good idea. Now it is a good idea. So just to review, let me try and get as simple a scenario as I can here. So, I'm gonna press, left. That's gonna result in, of course, trying to move forward, but the sausage is gonna move out from underneath us and move to the right. And because it's not braced against any kind of solid obstacle or wall or anything like that, the move will succeed. It'll push anything that's to the right of it, of course, because it's a moving object. And so, we're on top of it and we'll move to the right. Even though I pushed left. However, in this case, if I push right, then log rolling attempts to happen. The sausage tries to move left, but it's braced against the wall, so it can't move. So because it didn't move, now my movement to the right succeeds, and I can walk over here. So in order to dismount, you have to have a bracing surface behind you. And that's kind of what's going on here. So I think, therefore, I am, that what I need to do is move this sausage and shove it right here as my bracing surface. Because that will jam up the log roll and allow me to dismount off the ladder again. Because so far, I've only seen two ways I could potentially dismount off of this scenario. One is to have bracing behind me and walk off, and then change levels by going down a ladder. And the other one is incredibly complicated, because I think that would involve... I think if at some point I could somehow engineer a way to push a sausage out from underneath my own feet, then I would fall. That seems like a thing that a puzzle would have me do at some point. But that would also be a way to get me to lower a level. I think I want to have two sausages, not just one. I think I do want to do the double log roll, not the single log roll, in order to transport this over. Yeah, because this platform is critical. Being able to dismount, oh yeah, dismount horizontally, of course. As we all know, sausages do not roll in the direction that you don't want them to roll in. So let's see, I think we're building... Whoops. Well, that's no good. Right, so I tried moving backwards there, and of course I log rolled forwards. So I think what we do is we log roll like that, and then yeah. So what has that done for me? Well, it means I can... If I push all three of these, then it's... Then I can, like, for example, I could do this... Shove that there and repeat with the others, and I should be okay. That'll be how I rescue them out of the corner like this. I should be able to push all of them far enough that that works. Yeah, there we go. So, that was a tutorial level. Probably, I don't know if it could have gone in World 2, but it's certainly appreciated that it's very close to the start here in World 3. Actually, if I'm not wrong here, I don't think that's a wall. I think that's a stump. I think that is a tree somebody cut down. Curiouser and curiouser. Alright, this also looks simple enough, perhaps. It's just three sausages stacked on top of one another. So what could be so hard about that? So I need to dismount them at some point. Probably, I'm not sure if it's going to be right here, but probably as close to the grills as I can manage. Would I be able to pilot a single sausage from this part over to the next part? I don't know. That is a very specifically shaped tree, I imagine. So I can use it to do stuff like that, for example. The third dimension, folks. It's important. So, let me just learn. Can I get a single sausage through here? I imagine the answer is no. But maybe the answer is yes. Well, it kind of looks like it might be. Yeah, okay. Well, if I can disassemble this tower, then I would be set. But I don't see how you would actually do that. Yeah, because that's just going to slide like that. There's no way to elevate myself, so it's all going to be, like, these kinds of scraping procedures that, like, scrape the top off the bottom. Yeah, that is clearly designed to be impossible. Now, yeah, so as we've seen, we can use that tree to get the top level one off, but we need to be more creative for the next one. Now, could there be a way to, once I've done this, transfer one of these over to the other one? Like, as we've seen, once you create the S shape rather than the T shape here, or the block shape, I suppose you could say, then it's easier to disassemble. I mean, this is a puzzle all about disassembly, rather than, I guess, like, carving and sculpting. But I don't know, there's no real, well, there is an obstacle on the second level, it's the stump. Maybe we can work with that. The problem is that the stump is exactly the same as, like, the same profile, the same cross-section as this little bit of land here. So, I don't think we can use the stump to our advantage. Problem is, without that, I don't see any other way to separate this tower. Because I don't see... things on this level are not very helpful for disassembly purposes. They have to be on upper levels. So, I think that seems to imply that the tree is what we're working with here. However, the horizontal direction is not the only one in which we could use here. For example, we could do something like this. Yeah, so you see, that kept that in place, the topmost one. But it displaced the bottom like that. I don't know... that doesn't really seem to help much, mind you. But it is a thing we can do. Okay, well, I mean, I can do that, and leave that there. That is a technique we found out the other day. And that actually leaves a protrusion, which is interesting, but that's just gonna shove that off, won't it? Yeah, that's just gonna shove that off. Because that is not braced on anything. Well, I mean, we can do something like that. That just makes things even worse. We've discovered how to make things worse, folks. We did it. Yeah, that's not helping anybody. So what have we learned so far? It is occasionally useful to have one of these on top of your fork. But if it's only on top of your fork and not, like, embedded in it, then as soon as you turn, then it'll drop. So you can transport things horizontally this way, the way that you're already facing, but you can't turn like that. We can do silly things like this, but they're not that helpful. Although stabbing may actually turn out to be helpful in this puzzle, I'll have to think a little more about that. Because while we are stabbed in the lower sausage, we are not stabbed in the sausage we're carrying. But that only seems relevant if we can scrape it off, which is kind of presupposing the thing we're already trying to do. But it is an interesting thought. Okay, well, let's just experiment a little bit more. What happens if we're stabbed into the bottom one as we back into this? Then that happens, of course. That results in us carrying one sausage with another sausage on top of it, as you do. And still has not revealed any way to dislodge this middle one. That's our puzzle. Has been for the last little period here, but we'll figure something out. So the only thing, yeah, that seems to be the only thing that I can really think of, is figure out how to displace this bottom one by one. And then, somehow, like, once you have the S shape instead of this, block, then I figure we could roll it over here somehow and, use the trunk to dislodge the top one, but not have this bottom bit block the one that I'm rolling. That would get everything on the ground level, and then once everything's on the ground level, I can just put them all individually over here. I've got plenty of space in the middle here. This is plenty wide. And then all the individual ones I can just roll over here and everything will be fine. Because that runway past the grills here is very clearly set up to allow that kind of queue processing that we did in the previous puzzle. Okay. So it's a variation on what I'm already doing. That much is clear. We've already decided this doesn't lead to anything, right? Well, I mean, we can do that. That doesn't help anybody, but it's a thing we can do. So yeah, we can shove that off. But yeah, it's not going to lead to anything good, I think. Yeah, because we can't even unstab now. So stabbing facing west is probably not what we want, but stabbing facing east may have some potential. But yeah, these kinds of moves don't help. They do not induce any movement in the uppermost sausages, which is good to know. It would probably make things a little bit too easy in some cases. I don't suppose there's anything helpful we can do down here, right? I don't think so. There's no helpful features over there. No. Yeah, I don't know. It seems like no matter what move I make with this one, the top one is going to copy it, unless I can find, some way of scraping that, just moving the top, this top one that used to be the middle one, this one that's one layer above me, without moving the bottom one, or moving the bottom one in such a way that the top one can't copy it. Alright, I think I'm gonna leave this one off till later. That's alright. It's okay. And we'll consider ways to improve after that. Okay, this is potentially very worrying. Good to survey your domain every now and then, but you don't want to overdo it. Alright, let's see what's going on with this one. Got, yep, that's what that's relevant for. Got a nice big area here. But we gotta figure out a way to transport things. Well, that's a, yeah, that's narrow. We can work with that, so... Okay, so what if we use the pillars to our advantage? How would I stab this one? Well, I could stab like this. So for example, I could push this over here. Carry this with me. Now, can I log roll while facing the other way? No. Well, first of all, that's one layer below me. Oh, yeah, that's right. This is a two-layer tall wall, not a one-one, but I'm climbing the whole ladder in one motion. That's interesting. I would have guessed that I would have ascended one ladder tile per keystroke here, but only one keystroke makes me take the whole path. That could be very relevant later. Everything is relevant in puzzle games. Everything. Even the things you don't think are necessarily relevant. Right, now I've created a bridge. That's right, that's the whole point of this whole thing. So I can go over here, I can get over to the middle area. And I think I just have to do it again, but, reverse 90 degrees, of course, because that's what this game likes doing. So I think I have to... Yeah, how am I gonna do this, actually? Well, if that sausage is on the left half of this whole structure, then I can log roll it. Yeah, then I could log roll the vertical one across the horizontal one. At what point did this happen? And, yeah, so that happened over there. I might be able to fix that. I might be able to deposit it on the, or will I? No, I might not actually be able to do that because of, I could actually do that. Yeah. If I don't put it across all the way. Yeah. We're getting these things worked out. Sometimes you just have to look at these transitive properties, you know, things that don't change even when you move these things around. So I think what I'm going to do instead is leave that there. Don't put it all the way across. That's definitely a thing that this game does is make sure you know exactly what you're doing. I'm gonna just move that the long way over. Well, how am I gonna rescue that, though? Like that? I would like to drop that, but I can't. And now I'm definitely not getting that back. Okay, that's interesting. That is a way I can carry a sausage. By using a ladder to my advantage. So what happens if instead I do that the other way? Can I make that work for me? Well, I can drop that over there. That's not gonna help. Yeah, so a ladder is actually, interestingly enough, a way to make a strafing move, even if you're not stabbed into anything. Alright, I don't think that line of... I don't think that's going to lead to anything. I think I just need to do a better stab, which is going to be a westward stab instead of an eastward one. But I don't see how you would do that out here, so maybe it's about fixing things once it is actually in place. So let's do the same thing I was doing before, but maybe I can change what I'm doing in the middle part. I mean, I suppose I could do things like... Well, that doesn't really seem to help. Yeah, so far, with the Eastern Stab, all I have discovered how to do... is let go of it on this side. I think the shape of the platform precludes... Well, no, wait, no it doesn't. I can just do this. Yeah, and now it'll be on the west side of the of that particular sausage, which is critical. Right. So now that it's on the correct side here, now I think if I push that bottom sausage over there, the top one should stay on, I think. Yeah, of course. That's what we've learned so far. So now that I've shifted that one over, now I've got it on the left side like I want. So now I go over here. I can't shove that over because... why? Because it's also resting on top of my own head while I'm doing that. Okay. And so that's why it's left behind in that case, as opposed to when I was doing the same thing in the other case. And that didn't happen last time because it was on the right half instead of the left half, and so that top vertical sausage wasn't resting on my own head while I was doing this. Now, is there a way of getting rid of this? Not that I can tell. So, as I said before, I only seem to have options in this particular case when it's misaligned. When it's either misaligned 90 degrees from me, or when it's when I have some kind of vertical terrain to like scrape this off of me. So I don't think I have either of those things here. Yeah, I don't think so. All the terrain here is pretty simple. So, I think instead, I may have to fix things after I put that on the right half, after all. Okay, so let's try the right half again. See if I have any further insights as to the matter. Yeah, this is all a learning process. This is all a tutorial. It's all very hard, but it's still definitely a tutorial, for sure. In a manner of speaking. Now, right, that'll happen. Can I prevent that? Yeah, it's very awkward to turn around in a little tiny... I could do something like that. That would normally cause the top one to move over, but because because it's going across the terrain, that doesn't happen. So I can make little adjustments like that. In fact, can I do something similar to shove that over to the left? Can I make adjustments like that? I would need suitably shaped terrain to do it, but maybe I could. Oh, well, that won't work. Yeah, that... well, hold on, I have another ladder. Yeah, why don't I just disassemble this like so, and then maybe I can carry the vertical one up instead? Yeah, why can't I disassemble that and carry the vertical one up? I mean, I'm gonna need to actually pilot all this stuff around, but I should be able to do that. Yeah, why was I so focused on maintaining the same tower shape? I'll still need a stab like that, but... we'll have to shove that over, but that's fine. I can still disengage here and make this. I'm still waiting for the twist, though. I'm sure this part's gonna be miserable in some way I have not yet anticipated. Well, here's a way I can disengage. Sort of. I still need that part to be unblocked, though, which is an issue. Although, I could theoretically see a case where I log roll... oh, I need to get back to where I started. Oh, that could be... well, it could be a huge issue, but if I finish this off with a log roll of the, oh, that's another thing I just thought of just now. Let me finish that first thought first. If I finish this off with a log roll of this vertical, this vertical thing right here. Then I can go all the way across the grills and wind up on the left side and then be able to go back to the designated picnic area. But the thing that caught my eye while I was on the middle of all that sentence was that I can imagine a scenario where I need to log roll over to... log roll over to a ladder and then, like, climb up that midway. Like, I could certainly imagine that happening at some point. Anyway, I don't think that's the correct solution here. I think what I need to do instead is just figure out a way to dislodge this particular sausage. And I have not yet figured that out. So I can do things like that. That's not going to be any good to anybody. If I stab, I can do things like that. Oh, wait a second. Let's not gloss over this. I was carrying this so that it was on the top half of that sausage, but when I moved over here, I scraped I used terrain to brace the uppermost one so it wound up on the bottom half now. I think that's actually very important. That's an important step. So now I did this. So we figured out how to cook the bottom one, because I could do this no problem. But I need to figure out how to cook the other one. Well, actually, that's no problem, right? Because I wasn't going to log roll this all the way over anyway. Yeah, so if I can keep that on top, actually, if I can shove this over without causing that to move over. Yeah, if that doesn't fall yet, if that's on the right half of that rather than the left half, like if I can reproduce that but one square over to the left, then I'm actually set, I think. So how would I do that? Yeah, because if it's one square over to the east, then I make that similar move. I reproduce this to the left, but then I can go over here, log roll, put that down later, and the cooking works out better. But the problem is that I'm just like the parity is slightly off, that's all. So how do I fix that? Well, maybe I could reassemble that somehow. I don't know, that seems iffy. But it could maybe work. I would have to disassemble that, not over here, though. I would have to do that up here, I think. Because I think that would involve stabbing that and somehow still having room, I guess. This still seems kind of iffy. Yeah, I don't see that going anywhere good. Okay, I am... Okay, yeah, I'm not aligned with the ladder. Okay. Had to check these things, though. Oh, wait, I just restarted. Thankfully, I can undo with past a restart. That is not... absolutely not what I wanted to do. I thought I was, that was an impulse restart, for sure. That was the kind of thing I do when I think I want to restore back to a checkpoint. But, there's no checkpoints in this game. Thankfully, puzzles have not really been long enough that that's been necessary. I think even on the Great Tower, I don't think a checkpoint really would have helped that much. We're nearly there. It's just a little tiny implementation detail I'm not quite getting at this point. Let's back up a little further. Maybe I didn't want to disassemble that tower. Maybe there's just something smarter I could do with the tower itself. So what we want to do is shove this horizontal one over without there being a problem. Alright. We did figure out how to transfer halves. Which actually isn't as necessary as I thought, because I could probably just leave it at that anyway. No, wait, the problem was that this would wind up on top of my own head, that's right. That was the problem I was fixing. Yeah, so we solved that like so. But... is there anything else I can do with this beforehand? Not really, not that I can see. Because I'm stabbed into that half of it. Alright, that's a clever trick for turning around, when I wouldn't otherwise have enough space to do it. Just for the sake of humor, of course that's gonna happen if I do that. Is that in any way salvageable? It does create that 90-degree situation I was talking about earlier, so I'm willing to give that a try, briefly. But that's just gonna leave it on the ground, and I don't see any other way of interacting with it at the moment, so let's not let that happen. Okay, so rolling still very much an issue. Or we can mess with it from here. No. If it were on the top half, I could have done that. But it's too late now. But if it were on the top half, I couldn't have gotten it down here in the first place? Am I right? Maybe I might be wrong. Well, if it's in this position, I can walk on it. Which is not especially useful, but worth noting, I guess. Yeah, log rolling is probably... It's clumsy enough that you should probably only do it as an option of last resort when the puzzle explicitly suggests that you should do it. It's not an operation to enter into lightly. Yeah, actually, if I could just do that one move. Although, maybe that's enough. Maybe, did that actually change my parity? No, that only made it worse, didn't it? Yeah, because now I'm doing that. That's not going to be good for anybody. I mean, maybe, but now I can't rescue that from the bottom row anyway. So now it's condemned to live on that row for a long time. Okay. It's simple. The step I need here is simple, I think. I don't think any of the prior sections are going to affect this. I think it's just a small manipulation thing I'm overlooking here. Let's back up to... yeah, let's back up further. Let's back up to the... yeah, when we first crossed here. This is what I want. Alright, so that's the configuration we start with. We can adjust it slightly. Yeah, for instance, like that. Or like that. If we do, we're going to wind up in exactly the same problem we had the other time. So what I want is for this whole thing to be one tile over. There is not any... Okay, hold on. Let's see what happened here. So, why did that work? I think I understand why that worked. So, I think first what happened is I rolled that sausage from underneath this one. But then I used my fork to carry it over. In fact, I think technically it's resting on the fork rather than my sausage at the moment. So I think I'm just pushing the bottom one and carrying the top one. I think that's what's happening. Now is that close enough to what I needed? I think it is. No, not quite. Yeah, so I do that. Now that's over here. Now I log roll that. No, wait. I log roll it the other way. Yeah, log roll that over there. This one's done, but I only need to log roll this one once in order to complete it. And I will dismount on this side. And I'm done. Okay, that was pretty tough. There are multiple parts to that, but I just had to play around with that last one until I got it. How are we doing on time? We can probably call it here, I think. So next time, we'll either revisit that one, or probably more likely, we'll just play around with something else. But yeah, we're on World 3, and World 3 is harder than World 2.